guys, you don't know it, your girl Spice. I'm there to spice it up. Spice It Up is my weekly show where I cover the topics that are real to us. So with that being said, big up my big top sponsor, Magnum Tonic Wine. We're ready to take charge of things anytime, anywhere. Novelty Party Renters for these nice furniture, Best Buds for these lovely plants, and of course, my own brand, Faces and Laces, for my hair. Let's jump right into it and spice it up. You know it, go. I know a lot of you out there are probably wondering, what is Spice going to talk about today, or this week rather? Well, today I want to get into the thick of it all with a few ladies that have undergone procedures. You heard right. You know them nice body there? That we're going to talk about today. To achieve the ideal bodies. All right, now let us just stop you right there. Before you even go into the comment section and type away, this episode is to help our women out there understand the reason why these amazing women decided to make the body of their dreams. And I want to welcome my thick, good body friend them tonight, dancehall queen head top, Lisa Hyper and Chinny Unique. Hi. We're going to jump right into it and get into the song, because you know how it goes. Hi, ladies. How have you been?
I'm good. Thank
First,
you for
let
having
me check
me.
On you. How has COVID impacted your lives, your career? I know you individually have different aspects of your life, you know.
Yes.
I know you're a big tap dancer.
Yes, ma'am.
But COVID kind of slowed down a little part of
everything.
Everything.
And I also had the virus.
You can.
Oh, yes, I did.
Is that like a thing we tested it before the come in?
Last year, October, I caught it.
Last year, yeah. How was that for you?
It was a little bit shaken, but, you know, I try to keep the faith. I pray every morning because, you know, just people dying.
And when you catch a COVID, you pray?
No, I've been praying. Because... I've always prayed every morning.
Okay, that's
so if you
very
see me
good.
Walking on the road in the morning, talking.
Yeah, you're praying.
I'm not talking to myself, I'm praying.
That's
always, that's what I do every morning.
We have something in common. That's absolutely amazing. Mm-hmm. And I'm good to see that you got over COVID.
Yes.
And you are still here with us.
Amen.
Yes. Lisa, where you up to? How...
Up to a bag of things, man. But you know, I recently undergo surgery, so I'm not fully healed as yet.
Oh, really? It's recent for you?
Mm-hmm. Recent.
How long ago?
I did it in what? June. So you know, it take like 6 months before you're fully healed.
Nice. We are going to get into the nitty gritty of that to see how it was for you. Where you <being? laughs> We're going to get into the nitty gritty of that. I just want to check up on you ladies to see how you've been. What about you, Chinny Unique? What have you been up to lately?
Lots of work. I mean, the COVID opened so much doors for me.
That's
like
good.
So much like, my kids say, may I make more money now in the COVID than regular before, yeah.
Give me the secret. What do you mean? Oh, yeah, make more money.
Good management. Yes. Yeah, Lisa, big up yourself.
Oh, that's nice. That's
yes,
amazing.
I mean, like, I take my thing to a different level right now where I'm under management. And I think that's the best way for me right now because I am not where I used to be. I am up here. So you have to, you know, level up and get the things
every
right.
Every time. Yeah. I like that. Take charge of things every time, anywhere. I like that. All right. So now that we see that the ladies have been doing good, I've been doing extremely well myself. My album just came out 10 and you know, went number one on the first day. And you know, my big bad song go down there.
Yeah.
A bag of things. All right. So we can get into the nitty gritty now. A few of us, not all, but we want them hear from the horse's mouth. So I'll just throw the questions and everybody can be open and we have our discussion.
Okay.
How has surgery impacted your life?
Me?
Yes.
Well, you know, I had to do lipo and BBL because I needed the enhancements because I had hip dips and I didn't like them.
But it's shape good long time, I know you a long time. You've always been a thick girl with a nice, good body.
Yes.
So, baby, make sure I get dug in night. I make her get comfortable. Because the people, they have to know, you are one of the first person from Jamaica that came out publicly and post up a nice body.
Yes,
and you broke out Jamaica.
No, I did not.
Yes.
You know, I did not.
Well, talk to us about that. What made you just came out and just boldly just made
that? I'm already in the public eye, so it doesn't make sense I try to hide it because someone's going to figure it out. So I just came straight out with it.
That's true.
Yes.
And what was that procedure? What did you get done, first of all?
I had lipo, BBL, and breast lift.
And you went back three different times?
No, one time.
What do you mean?
Everything one time on the table.
My God.
You get to the point. You really did get to the point. Everything just one time.
Everything one
and
time.
And that was done in Jamaica?
No, it was done in Dominican Republic.
Oh, wow. Wow. All right. Let me see our next picture with my friend. Because I know the girl, but it's still real good and nice and proper. So, yeah.
Aye.
Look good. Were you comfortable with what you got done or with your work? Were you comfortable with everything? Is there anything you would do differently?
Well,
or
I always,
if you think you're perfect now?
I think I'm good now, but I always wanted a smaller boobs. I don't know why. Because, you know, sometimes working out, dancing, the breast is just all over in the face.
Oh, so you had a larger, you had a big cup size?
No, it was just the same as this. Not much difference.
Oh, okay.
Just a little lift, but it's back to normal.
Okay, that's good. That's amazing. Chin Unique, talk to me. Because you're bigger, you're popular in the streets. Did you get any work done at all?
I would say no. I only had a facelift.
What you
like,
say?
Facelift.
You say no, you never done a surgery?
No.
Talk to me, Chin. You facelift. Just have a nice body, just say they never do
but
nothing.
But I always shape good, though. I always
so
shape good.
So all the people them say you do surgery?
Where? What am I proved? Do I do any surgery? A lot of my followers know that I always work out and from 2014, 15, I think I've been using Your Closet One products, also training Maurice. And everybody know I'm a gymaholic, so I always train my waist. And people will follow me, of course, always I post up my workout video and also post in my story promoting training your waist and eating healthy.
That's amazing. You look great. You look absolutely
yes.
great. That's
and
good.
The little abs are come because maybe not more on the abs. Honestly, I always wanted abs. I think it looks sexy.
Yeah.
So it all comes with the eating healthy.
Well, me think
it
get work was done. Me think you and I already go at the time go do
but
eating.
Jesus!
Why not the egg? But talk well, talk well.
I don't know.
Let me see your back. Let me see your back. Spice, I want you to touch you. Me, I look for the look of something away.
No, look at something that they miss.
They must have wondered. I wonder what Spice has said. She wants to see her back. For most of you in TV world who don't know, normally when you get surgery, you do a lipo. The in surgeon mark is in the
back. The center of the back.
The center of the back. You hear what she know?
Ah!
You hear what she know?
Well, I was wondering what you're feeling for. You shouldn't be feeling for anything. You should be looking for something.
Oh, because yeah, sometimes it disappears. Oh, yeah. You can't see it. It depends on the skin. So let me look. Let me look if you have a little spot in your back.
I don't
have
nothing in your
oh.
What?
Your well, back is
she's
clean.
Saying your back clean, you never do nothing. But that's good. But anything
I don't,
else?
I have mostly muscles because I went to the spa like a couple weeks ago because I always do my massage because, you know, we as dancers have injury. But sometimes I go there and like, when the lady was massaging my back, she was like, yo, one side of your body, like, over to the right side, I have more muscle than the other side. So, because honestly, me don't know what back muscle look like. Cause remember, so me just a workout, you know.
Right.
But when she was massaging it, she was like, her hand was doing like this, and she said, oh, one side is more higher than one, so I need to work on it, like, lots of muscles. So,
right.
But kind of glad still, cause I like my back look firm.
Right.
Yeah.
That's very
so,
good.
Yeah.
So you've had anything done?
I did a facelift in 2017.
Really?
I've been struggling. Me?
But you've always been beautiful though. You
no, I have a chubby cheek. I hate it. I what hate chubby mean? Cheek. Like, my face did fat and they used to call me chubby cheek and I did not like it.
What do you mean?
I did not like it. My face was too fat and round and I have a double chin right here.
Like mine?
So I went and I did tread lift, like what it do, the enhance the face where they do the PDO tread and it lift the cheek. So when you do your makeup, your face and your cheekbone look small. So even the contour just look flawless.
Walk me through it. What is that procedure like? Are you asleep?
No. It adds. Me, I tell you, it adds.
What?
Yeah, but
so
she numb it. Yeah, but it's a long needle and she push it through here.
What? Wait a second.
It's hard, but I mean, it was worth it for me because I like my face after. But I really like it because, as I said, my insecurity was here, right? And I didn't like it. Like, everybody say, oh my God. And them always, your face is so fat. And I just feel like one little baby, them play with their cheek. I was so insecure about it. So, like, no, like, even the workout, it helps with hair too. Because when you work out, your face gets smaller.
Yeah. Well, actually, in Corona, St. Martin locked down for 3 months straight. Like, we're closed down, can't go nowhere. So, okay, eat. And I went to like 220 pounds. And I went to the doctor. The doctor said, you're overweight, you're obese. I'm like, obese? me look sexy, my bottom just big.
Right.
Me obese, me sexy. No, you're obese for your height. I said, all right then. So I went to the States and I said, all right, I make up my mind, I'm gonna do gym. And I did gym for 3 to 4 months and I lost 37 pounds.
Wow, that's amazing.
37 pounds.
Yes.
What
you do?
Well,
give me the secret. You can't come so far.
I had 1 meal a day, every day.
You're not gonna lose no weight.
That's impossible.
That's impossible.
It's not.
Me not gonna lose
meal?
No weight. It's not
one
gonna work
meal
for me.
Not even me. Not even me.
If you're busy,
it
you,
must be crazy.
Busy,
I would eat. Me too. Me eat too because I don't eat after 6.
Listen,
but
you don't eat as much.
Talk to us, Lisa.
You don't eat as much as me.
What? First of all, what did you get done?
I got lipo. The
I'm glad move, you know, come out. All right, me no batch, me no, you know. Yeah.
That's amazing. I'm glad you came out good as well. How do you deal with the negative criticism? And I don't want people to be posting anything negative under this video. I want you to think about it first because these ladies, they don't have to be open to you, share their journey, their dream. So think about them just being so open with their surgery. And a lot of times, us women, we have our, you know, we're not so perfect and we want to enhance a little bit. But how have you dealt with the negative criticism that surrounds getting surgery or, you know, your whole body done or changed? Have you ever had any encounter where you see a negative comment or you deal with it?
Block and delete. That's it.
Block and delete.
But Anika, but everybody did love your body though. Like
everybody loves my body.
The feedback for me say everybody love Anika body. Like because she didn't have that whole booty and stuff, so it just blending. So I honestly really like her body. A lot of people honestly as me can say it. And Instagram, you know, social media win.
You can't tell me.
Yeah. Like, regardless.
People want to say good and bad. Yeah. Right.
Yeah, I got a few people.
What has the feedback been for you?
Well, I've gotten great feedback.
That's good.
You know, but as me say, you still have to go skull
true, true,
people.
True. A lot of people talk down on having surgery. A lot of people talk down on it. But they only talk down on it because they don't have the money.
To do it.
But once them get the money,
Them gone.
Yeah,
because exactly. Them have a one know which doctor to do. We're going to drop it in the we're going to drop the link below. Speaking about money, surgery is very expensive. Mm-hmm. How did you get to pay for the surgery? Was it a payment plan? what is somebody name? Apple Pay? Where name? Apple Pay? It's a lot of money. It's expensive.
They have payment plan in the States, though, things. For sure.
It's very expensive, right? Mm-hmm. So what's the cost like? Or oh, you get paid?
How was it? What's your cost? I would like to know your business. I would like to know your business.
You don't want to display that.
Why?
You don't want nobody
well,
feel like me.
Well, surgery is very expensive.
Even
very.
After the surgery, expensive because there's still a fair do lymphatic massage after. And that
every
expensive
week. To do a surgery costs maybe like a 10,000 US, like a million Jamaican something. Or it depends on what you're doing. Mm-hmm. To get a pair of breasts is maybe like a 7,000 US. or to do a full BBL is like a 15,000. So that's like 2 million Jamaican.
Or you know, a about that.
Something like that.
Mommy makeover.
I got discounts.
Mommy makeover.
Yes, I got discounts.
Expensive as well. Because you do everything. Breasts.
Not so much PM, my God.
All right, so would you say that after you did the surgery, well, she's young, she just recently did it, but did you make more money? Was it better for you? You know, how impactful was it after the surgery comparing to before you had it done?
Yes, more money. The price went higher.
Oh, boy, the price go higher.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
So performances, you charge more because
yes,
you have
ma'am
a body makeover.
And everybody want to see the body.
Oh,
so they have to see the body.
I don't say I'm a fear more.
I was over there.
But the thing is, you know.
Lisa, tell the truth. You never know that. You have to go charge more money.
Yes.
You have to go charge more.
As an entertainer, you have to invest in your body. You have to invest in your craft. you know, because you can't be going back. Even if you're doing the same dance move, something has to come new. Your outfit, your
everything
hair.
Different
something
now.
Has to come. Yes. To
me, I never know.
Everything has to come new.
You spice.
I know. To the PM,
I know.
To the PM, I'm going to go through. I don't even want a man touch me right now.
Right.
Yeah, give me some time.
I
don't want no man touch me right now. To the PM.
Speaking about surgery, I know us ladies were always one-sided. Mm-hmm. How would you feel if your partner had a surgery done? Let's say, for example, your man do a surgery on the penis for enlarging it. Mm-hmm. Are you against that? Are you opposed to that?
In penis, good way there.
So if him do surgery, if he get the penis look a little larger, you wouldn't date him? Would you feel confident to probably tell Mrs. Spice, you know, say my man penis bit small and he had to do a surgery to enhance it?
Not needed. It would have been too big now.
Well, me wouldn't mind.
You like big things.
You wouldn't mind.
Me wouldn't disregard him.
I wouldn't judge him either.
Like
if him feel like that, I gotta give more. You know, like more confidence. Why not?
Yeah, mood.
As long as he's not too big. Because you might be with a partner, you know, and his penis is a little small.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So how would you go to him and say, baby, you know, you can do a surgery? Because you probably love a man and him probably lacking in the bedroom a certain way and him can do surgery for enhance. You
I've
know,
been done that
before. For spice it up. What you say?
I've been done that road before. I talked to somebody with Jesus Spice.
Come on, Chini, I can't talk with you, man.
But I'm being real. I've been with somebody who have a little teen penis, of course, but.
All right, where them names start with?
Me, no, what? What?
But
call them the first letter.
Where them names start with?
But
just the first letter.
It's not a popular person because I don't date popular people.
Right, yeah, just the first letter.
Huh?
No, make sure.
All right.
Just set me up.
But you tell him? Did you have discussion with him that, or you just work with it and then end up still
honestly,
liking?
Honestly, you know what happened? Me never did like him in our first part.
And
then
my
girlfriend said that didn't happen because we had date.
So I never did like him.
But listen.
You did tell him say anybody like him in our first part?
No.
Oh, pull him now, watch this.
Lisa, stop interrupting. All right.
But honestly, it wasn't to me. It wasn't the size that mattered to me because I get for real.
Size matters. Right.
It never matter because me did get for like him and get for love him. Somebody kind of put that aside.
Yeah,
so in that way, see, if that can't pleasure me, I have something put down aside, you know? So.
Oh. What is
so
that?
Our dildo.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
She have our dildo on the side. So.
I like, listen to me. You see me? I rather use that more than go dash out. My good friend.
Yourself.
How much do you have?
No dildo.
Anika? What?
I own three, so I'm just asking.
Yeah.
It's like it's really hot. I need a more.
You know, sometimes you're traveling.
I own
four. You're on tour. You need something. What are you gonna do?
What do you mean?
You start getting that feeling, you know. But it starts getting warm.
I don't understand.
No,
like,
what do you
mean? Explain it. Elaborate to me, please. Elaborate.
Yeah, no.
I don't understand.
You know, you're traveling. You get lonely at times.
Right.
You know, when a man out of the club where you just perform.
Where you don't know.
Yes.
Right. So you just travel with your dildo.
Oh, yes, I do.
Well, you have a special one still I travel with, you know.
What name?
Lipstick.
Oh, my ear. Boy.
I travel.
That's the little one like this.
You ladies can take the floor. I'm included. I don't know about that.
I travel with a 7-inch.
The lipstick.
What?
Our customs saw it in my suitcase one time. It was right on top.
We have to change the topic from surgery to dildo and then the announcement.
I never owned one before. Never had one. Yeah. Just use my finger.
And that's it.
That gets really hot. I really need a mask now.
I don't feel comfortable at like an insert. Like,
but you don't have to insert though.
Eh? You don't have to. A person that used yeah, anything to insert either.
I don't like. That's why you have special types. You have the clit one where you do not insert.
Yeah, some of them don't come so with my finger.
My finger can't do that.
You know, sometimes you can get tired. You get tired.
Listen, every time you see Lisa, I'm very sorry. I'm never doing this.
Yo, my God, I get tired.
Are you still doing this?
I'm not going to do it.
Jesus!
They tell you, but that's the truth.
Yeah, because sometimes. But if him come to me and say, I'm going to do it, I support
him. Yeah, I support him.
Because at the end of the day, our sex life will be
All right, let's talk about the double standards in doing a surgery and bleaching. Is it the same thing? Because a lot of people who bleach, them condemn a person that do surgery. It's the changing of your body and the appearance. What do you think about, what do you think about somebody bleach versus doing your body? Is it the same thing or are you against bleaching? Or do you consider it
I'm not an against addition, bleaching, like a, but I would not bleach. I love my skin.
I love that. Proud of my color, yeah, I'm proud. For me, black and beautiful. So we not bleach, we not pray, we not chat, we not eye gal. My money make a gal look so fine. Some gal be like, we eat them.
I lighten my skin from time to time. You know, we're not doing it round the clock, but you know.
I mean, it's not a part of the topic, but why do you think you need to lighten your skin and you're already a lighter shade of black? Is it a trend? Is it, you know?
No, it wasn't. It wasn't because of a trend to
But you're already pretty and you're light. You are a lighter shade of black. So why you think you need to go lighter? I just want to understand it because I mean personally, never
some people
get to ask somebody
why lighten them skin for different reasons.
Yeah,
some do for the eye.
Some do it because it's a trend. Some do it because they have one and two spot on them leg when they try to get rid of dermatologist there.
Right.
Because when you go to dermatologist, the same lightening product they might give for use. It just may be stronger. More personal and stuff, so
maybe more medicated, right?
Yes, so like now I'm using a dermatologist product on my face, and it lightens me just the same, like the cream, like the bleaching cream. You understand what me say? Just more expensive. Some people lighten them skin because they work in a sun burn them up, so they might lighten them skin. So it's various different reasons. We did brown, but one at a time. Before I was established out there, I did get real dark, sun did burn me up. I did have to get rid of that sunburn there. So I rub.
So why do you feel like when you get dark as a sunburn?
Because a sunburn. And I like me never black. You understand? I never have a
light complexion, tone.
So the sun did burn me up for real.
I like to see you when you stop bleach. I would like to see you if you stop bleach, and I can bet anything on it that you probably would look better.
Yeah?
Alright,
I'm going to stop bleach for you.
I can't make me see it.
Yeah, but as I say, from I did surgery, when I
rub nothing upon your body. So, and see, then I tell you, look on her. She look now?
I just use bio oil, that product, bio oil. I just use that, so.
Yeah. All right, we are about to wrap up soon, but you know, I want you to, you know, what advice would you give to someone out there that wanted to get surgery done? I probably would tell them not to do it.
Well,
what's your
advice? I wouldn't encourage a person to do it, and I wouldn't discourage a person to do it.
That's also a good advice. Each is own.
That's right.
Some people, they have them own thing.
Just do your research. Do your research first. If you make up your mind and say you're going to do it, do your research. You know, a lot of doctors have debts, and a lot of complications, so you have to do your research.
It's very risky.
Very risky.
Doing surgery is very risky.
As I said, I wouldn't encourage anyone to do it, and I wouldn't discourage
age has a lot to do with it too. Maybe a young girl who's 18 years old and probably don't have any kids, mm-hmm. I would tell her to wait until she has a lot of time.
That's true.
You know, you have a lot of time ahead of you. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, if you want to do surgery, we're going to give you the doctor's number.
I mean, everybody make their own decision, you know?
All right. So, I mean, thank you, ladies, for being so open to not just myself, but to the world. Mm-hmm. And, you know, expressing yourself and your journey. I truly appreciate it. And I hope that the viewers out there will appreciate us just being open to them so that, you know, they can have a better understanding of surgery life. But with that being said, I also want to know what you're up to. What's the new life for you right now? What's the new thing? I mean, you must have businesses. We know Selisa, big top artist. You must have video. Where you go? Show to the new body.
Yes, yeah, all about sculpture right now. Basically, I did sculpture before I went to surgery.
And is that a song about surgery?
I did it before I did the surgery. I didn't want to call it designer body.
Right.
So I call it sculpture.
Nice.
Yeah, mineral bars give the name sculpture, which I love.
Nice.
The video about the drop. Nice, creative.
Sculptures.
You know, I can go out with myself because I'm
right,
not ready again.
Yeah, I like that.
Also, I'm about to launch a sanitary napkin line.
Nice.
Female sanitary napkin.
That's nice.
Plush. Naturally comfortable,
That's good, that's amazing.
A sanitary line.
Every woman need that.
Every
so that's a very good business. I like that. Look out for Lisa Hype business called Plush. What are you up to now?
I'm not living in Jamaica no more.
Oh, really? You migrate gone left way?
Oh, yes.
It's been
a while. I'm now living in St. Martin.
Oh, you're fine, man, over there?
Yes.
Then that's a tattoo.
Oh, that's a good accent, migrate left.
That means I'm an accent migrate too. Then that's a tattoo, Anika. So you're still married? You're second girl? That one's a man.
I settled down a long time, from 2017.
What you mean?
I'm 1 month from 2017 till now.
That's very good, because some woman cannot say that.
Mm-hmm. And me and my partner, we have a clothing store in St. Martin. It's called A&A Fashion.
Nice.
On Front Street.
Yeah.
That's amazing. A&A Fashion.
Yes, ma'am.
I like that. Mm-hmm. Businesswoman.
Yes, ma'am.
Business mogul.
You know, after dancing, you have to have something to fall back on.
I
can't be dancing for the rest of my life, because you know,
I like that.
The ankle, the knee, the back, the neck.
Yeah.
It not gonna work straight through.
I like that. And you have the body to model your clothes. So I'm sure you do that.
Yes, ma'am.
That's amazing. Congratulations
Thank
on your
you.
Business.
And I also dance for Conscience.
Big up to Conscience.
Yes.
Pay for it. Pay for it. My body good. Pay for it.
Yeah.
Pay for it. Pay for it. Pay for it in a wallet. My jacket. Big O's. You pay for it. Big up Conscience.
Yeah,
right.
That's
right there. What about you, Chini Unique? What have you been up to?
I am kind of crossing over to the influencer world right now. So, the COVID kind of changed a lot of things, and it kind of opened a lot of doors for me. Because as you can see, I'm a Fenty Savage brand ambassador. A lot of people don't know that. So,
I never know that you're a Fenty ambassador.
Yeah.
Is that recently?
No, it's like a year.
Yeah,
from last year, and I was actually the first brand ambassador in Jamaica.
Really? So we never know that.
That's
an amazing accomplishment.
Because, yes, it is. And I started with my team, my manager, of course, Lisa, big up yourself. She was the one that put me on a bigger platform. Mm-hmm. I am now working with overseas brand like Honeybun, Fenty, and a lot of like a big brand soap company and a lot of other brands. So it's
kind.
I am happy because I did not see myself in this.
To me,
I'm elevating. I'm moving from a dancer to an influencer, and I know that I influence a lot of people.
That's
so
amazing.
I just want it. You know, a lot of people won't know. So all right, then Chini is a Fenty brand ambassador because a lot of people now go pre that because you know me kind of more laid back and I'm a humble with it. So if me get a big contract or a big sign or something, I'm not going to really jump and put it out there. I make my work speak for itself.
That's amazing.
And to me, I feel like anybody who recognize will recognize. A lot of people not going to want to recognize because they might believe, so, she get it. she's a nobody, you understand? Mm-hmm. But I just no keep on. No, that's what they say. That's I'm not saying say. Me, but I right. just show prove them wrong. Because mm-hmm. guess what? Right now, I am one of the popular influencers right now. A lot of people, a TV, right now, a TV show, a TV show in VH1 Link Me. Right. They want me to, I think it's Chance, something about Chance, and a lot of influencer on Instagram in the US on it. And they reach out to my manager and said, listen, they would like me to be one a part of the casting. And that is a huge deal because definitely. I am cool. not, they right. see my profile and exactly. see that, listen, this girl look like she fit for it, you know.
Definitely.
So at least big things are going from over there.
I'm
it's not just here.
That. Don't
so,
stop.
I'm happy and I'm overwhelmed. And as I said, I just keep on the same route. Right, I just put that first.
Silence right. the naysayers. I'm so happy to hear that. You've heard yeah. from all these beautiful ladies, including myself. And I want to thank you so much for joining us. So with that being said, big up yourself, Chinny Uni.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Miss Lisa Hyper, for coming through and being so open with
my
us.
My pleasure.
And of course, heads up, Anika.
City Girls for a Queen, yeah.
City Girls, what? Oh, I forgot you didn't win the Omach Million
Dollar
yes. for the City Girls World Competition. Yes. You're not talking yes, things ma'am. Them. You can't stay there. You're not what me about and talk the things them. City Girls big twerking competition, but you're part from before then. So let's yeah, talk man. About the big top Jamaican dancer. Mm-hmm. Remember me, you when I first person was see and tell you say you're bad.
Yes.
From when you just a come, from when you come and sound, from Portmore Dancehall Queen, and you go for your head, you used to do the drop dead sub that me nearly put. Listen, these girls, they have come a far way, and I'm super proud of each and every one of you. With that being said, I just want to say big up to my thick body, friend them, Dancehall Queen Head Top, Lisa Hyper, Chinny Unique, who came through and taught the things them and spice it up for them nice good up body. Remember, make we know how you feel, so just jump in at the comment section, be nice to these ladies, and spice it up. Shout out to Novelty Party Rentals for the nice furniture, faces and laces for the hair. Magnum Tonic Wine, ready for take charge of things tonight. So big up to all of my loyal fans across the world. And make sure say on a tune in next week for more Spice It Up.